for 70.
Oh. I reckon you could have got long odds for that margin and anywhere.
Tony Ronaldson doing a bit of a jig on the sideline. So the clock just running down. Tigers will have to hurry up and throw up the shot. Wasn't a good one. Drimmick comes up with the ball. 4 seconds to go. Parkinson, the last shot of the game for three. It's there! It's a victory to Parkinson. What a way to finish for the South East Melbourne Magic. They have absolutely destroyed the Melbourne Tigers in the third and deciding game. 108-70.
Mitsubishi Challenge champions are the South East Melbourne Magic.
What a big, big victory for South East Melbourne as the players meet mid-court.
What a great series and what two fantastic basketball clubs.
Some Tigers...
A long hot summer had given the Tigers plenty of time to reflect and come to terms with the humiliating defeat fierce rivals the Magic handed them in Game 3 of the 1996 Grand Final. Up until that championship decider, Melbourne's season could hardly be faulted.
A loss like that, and I suppose the way we lost is certainly something you try to forget very quickly, but we have to carry that with us, and I think that trying to be objective about it and look at our season last year, by and large, we're very, very satisfied with the performance of the team, except for just one we'd like to call aberration in that last game. But so we certainly can go into this year with a lot of confidence in the fact that we did very well last year, and hopefully, as I said, with these small changes we've made to our lineup and some improvement with the younger guys, that'll be enough to take us to that next step and ultimately a championship.
After 8 seasons with the Tigers, import Dave Simmons was released to the Newcastle Falcons. His replacement was a highly credentialed 25-year-old with a reputed vertical leap of 104 centimetres.
I know it's going to be rough playing here in Melbourne because the Tigers have always been a great team, and I want to come in and add to that so we can continue to be a great team, hopefully win the championship.
With 3 less teams in the competition, season 97 was always going to be the strongest in NBL history.
Well, I see some of the good teams from last year being stronger again, and I think we'll be one of those good teams that will be stronger this year than last year. I think there'll be more size in the league this year, and with the depth of talent that we've got, as it has been the last 4 or 5 years, each year seems to have been at least a marginal step up in the year before, and sometimes we've had good step up.
The first few weeks of the new season were tough on the Tigers. Lang was still learning Melbourne's system, and centre Mark Bradkey was absent playing out a season in the NBA. Tip-off was mid-April, and the Tigers' first assignment was in Brisbane, where they opened with a loss, but made amends the following night in Townsville.
Copeland lets it go!
Oh, that's it!
Oh my goodness! You have got to be kidding. Leonard Copeland just fires away a three-pointer.
Round two, and not even 43 points from Gaze could get the Tigers over the line against Perth. With 1 win from 3 games, Mark Bradkey rejoined the team and was eager to get amongst the action after spending most of his NBA season on the Philadelphia 76ers bench.
I was saying last night I had the first practice with the Tigers, and I touched the ball more times at that one practice than I did the whole time I was in the States, so it was quite a shock.
There's Bradkey. Good to see him back in Australia. Lob pass. That's a good start. Gaze to Bradkey. A little mini alley-oop. And that'll give Mark Bradkey plenty of confidence. Welcome back to Melbourne. Really spots up. Bradkey the rebound. Rebound number 11 for the big fella. Goes all the way. Coast to coast.
Bradkey's come back as a guard.
The lack of court time and match fitness wasn't evident as Bradkey powered past the Adelaide 36ers with 31 points and 18 rebounds.
Bradkey, sensational rebound. Oh, that is fantastic.
The victory was soured the following afternoon when the club was informed Bradkey should not have played as he hadn't obtained the proper clearances from the NBA. Just hours prior to the clash against the Magic, Bradkey was told he would have to sit out the derby. The Tigers were understandably angry at the decision. There was no better opposition to take it out on than last year's champions.
Copeland, Gordon for three. This will tie it up. That's it! Score! Melbourne Park. Tigers 90, Magic 90.
In overtime, the Magic had the last roll of the dice.
Tigers in front. 7 seconds left in overtime. Magic need to score, otherwise the Tigers will pinch it. A two-pointer and win
it's
it.
It's going to go up.
Talbot, the money man, on the drive. Misses. Anthony misses. The Tigers have won it. The Tigers have stolen the game. One of their best victories in the history of their club. Without Mark Bradke, have a look at the Tigers. The Magic are shocked, and that is a sensational victory from the Melbourne Tigers. They won it in overtime. 97 to the Magic, 96. What a game of basketball.
During the week, the Tigers were stripped of their victory over Adelaide. The club was furious, to say the least.
Oh, it's horrendous. You know, I think that, you know, unfortunately, it's bureaucracy, it's a technicality. And as I said, I don't know of any coach or player in the competition that would support this decision. You know, I'm sure if I played under Dave Claxton with the Australian team, I'm sure if you ask him who won the game, of course he's going to say we won the game.
As a result of today's ruling, the Tigers will move from 7th to 9th spot on the NBL ladder. In 1996, the Tigers' regular season was 21 wins, 5 losses. After just 4 weeks of this season, the Tigers have already dropped 5 games.
You can imagine how you feel when you win a game, but then all of a sudden, 2 or 3 weeks later, you lose it, how disappointing it is. But, it puts us in a more precarious situation, but we've been in this situation before, and it's still relatively early in the season, so we've got a long way to go, and hopefully we can reverse that result.
But a comprehensive victory to the Perth Wildcats, 108 to the Melbourne Tigers 85. It's been a very dirty weekend for the Tigers.
Traditionally, the Tigers had a habit of starting seasons slowly. Their 2-win, 5-loss record was by no means their worst. But in early June, when the situation plummeted to 3-8, they were in serious danger of missing the playoffs for the first time since 1988.
Now, I don't feel like the season's lost, or, you know, that we've lost form to a point where we can't regain it, or we can't get some positives out of what's happened over the first few weeks either. So, you know, it's just a matter of trying to work our way through it and get out of it.
Come October, we'll be in the playoffs. We'll look back and say we had a terrible start, but we got our stuff together, and I still feel comfortable about making the playoffs and going from there.
But from an individual standpoint, it presents new challenges, and I'm excited about the challenge of testing myself and ourselves to see how we do in this situation. So in some senses, it's almost fun to having to go through with it. I think that you can get a little bit complacent, and you get in a routine and a rhythm, and you're always winning, as we have for the past 10 years. It's never been a question whether we'll make the playoffs, and we're always there. And I mean, that's a lot of fun. But I think that the opportunity we have now, which has come through adverse situations, is something that we can draw on and say, well, let's really have a look at this and approach it as a new challenge and test ourselves.
Injuries certainly weren't helping turn things around mid-season. The most serious was to Jarvis Lang, with a degenerative bone condition in his knee. Against the Sydney Kings, he could only watch as the Tigers lost their 4th in a row.
Melbourne! Oh, that was so good! Oh!
With just 3 wins from their first dozen games, one of the most talented teams in the competition was crumbling, second last on the ladder.
And the Kings go from strength to strength in season 1997. For the Tigers, well, there's still a little bit of hope left, but not much.
Days later, Melbourne awoke to this article in the Herald Sun, which suggested the coach's time was up.
Particularly given you're dealing with someone like my father and his reputation and what he's done for the sport, for the club, you know, he certainly did not deserve a article like that.
Personally, do you feel hurt by that?
Oh, of course I feel hurt by that, and you know, mainly because I don't think it was fair. And I think that you know, in all aspects of what we do, we all have strengths and weaknesses, and you know, I think that the attack that was made on my dad, blaming him for the situation we're in this year, without taking any, not even mentioning the circumstances for which the club has gone through this year, I think is wrong, and really doesn't deserve that.
While Andrew was clearly upset by the article, Lindsay's response was far more circumspect.
So, Lindsay, did the paper put you off your cornflakes this morning?
No, not at all.
What's your response to it?
Oh, you know, I certainly respect Chris's right to have a view on what my role could or should be with the Tigers. I mean, that's open for anyone to consider that. And it's reasonable for other people to have similar views if they wish.
The chief criticism levelled at the basketball veteran has been that his job as general manager of the VBA has restricted his commitment to the Tigers.
I don't give as much time as I would prefer to our team. But that doesn't mean to say that the team is disadvantaged by that.
I'm pretty confident. Do any of the other guys feel that our performance has ever been jeopardised by his commitments?
At the end of the day, one of basketball's great icons is certain his days are far from over.
I think Lindsay Gaze will be there in one form or another for a little while yet, you see. But obviously the clock is ticking. I'm certainly not immortal. I've never claimed to be immortal.
Changes were made. Jarvis Lang was replaced by Marcus Timmins, who had spent the previous season with the Illawarra Hawks. Instantly, the Tigers looked more of a threat, winning three of their next five games.
Short Timmins. This will be spectacular.
With just a top six to aim for, Melbourne believed they could make the grade. Understandably, not many outside the organisation shared their belief.
How many wins do you think you'll need to get in the top six?
I'm not too sure. I've only sort of briefly looked at how other teams are going, and I think that probably 16 and 14 will get you there. I personally think we can do a lot better than that. I think that we can still go through the remainder of the season and win the vast majority of our games. And when we look at our season last year, we went 21-5, and we went on a stretch where, you know, we had 3 months where we didn't lose a game, and I don't see why that can't happen again.
At the moment, they're winning the battle on the boards, 20-15. Gaze with the spin move, Giddy somehow.
Great assist.
And to Bradley with the dunk.
Mid-July saw the commencement of one of the most amazing winning streaks in Australian sports history.
Smith loses it.
No call on the play.
Great play, Giddy. Tigers are going to win it. Timmins, Bradkey, back to Timmins for two.
In week 14 against the league-leading Magic, the Tigers' seven-point victory did a lot to restore the team's confidence.
Andrew, the Tigers have been a bit of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. You guys are certainly Dr. Jekyll tonight. Magic didn't play badly, but you guys just played better.
Yeah, it was a really tough game. There was never really anything in it. And when you're in a bit of a crisis like we are, it makes it a very, very nerve-wracking situation. But I think in the end, you know, Leonard struggled in the start for him to come through like that, and we saw the value of Marcus Timmins tonight, so hopefully we can carry on from here.
Discarded by the Illawarra Hawks, Marcus Timmins was the key behind the resurrection. He brought an explosive game and a bit of showtime to Melbourne Park.
What about what were your first impressions coming to the Tigers? Obviously you played against us last year. What did you think of the Tigers? What's the reputation that we have amongst others out there?
I feel like this. When it's totally different than being down in Illawarra. I mean, I had so much pressure at the point of being there as an import, you know. If I make one mistake, you know, I feel like, damn, I might have to be up out of here the next day, you know what I'm saying? But here, I feel more comfortable. You know, I feel involved with everybody. Everybody likes me. The atmosphere is great, you know, we're communicating. The coach, he'll sit down and just sit there and like, hey, you ain't doing that right, or you're doing this right, you know. I feel like I'm home and everything, you know.
What about your good friends with Leonard?
Yeah,
you're hanging out a lot with Leonard.
I hang out with Leonard, you know. He's a good lucky player, you know. As in gambling wise, whatever you want to sat pat, you know, whatever. But he's a good person, you know.
What about back home? Are you from a big family, or because we had Jarvis here and he was one of 13 kids?
13.
What's your record?
Well, I got I got four brothers, three sisters. I'm the shortest in my brothers.
The shortest?
The shortest.
And the youngest?
And the youngest.
If someone had to say, Marcus, what's the best thing you can do on a basketball court, what would it be?
Somebody give me an opportunity, give me one step on them. I'd take them baseline. If nobody helps out, I'd be happy to just go up on them, do a dunk like this on them. And if they jump at me, laying on the floor, and I just get on top of them, just walking back and forth. But then like boom, black suits fill the room up with the quickness, talk with the witness.
Does it take much rhythm to get this action going?
I don't know about you, Dre. You know, we have to work on that point. You know, now, you can sit down and work on it.
How can you give me, like, how do you start? How do you learn how to
get that?
Yeah.
You do? Just get your hands, you know, get the little shoulder shaking like
that. So it's a shoulder shake.
Get the shoulder, then you can rock it.
You rock it.
Then you rock it back up.
Rock it back up.
Rock it to this side. Then if you want to put it all together, just like that.
Right.
After six consecutive wins, the Tigers found themselves in the top six, and they could do no wrong.
Well, we've had the full circle of emotions this year, going from the depths of despair to reeling off eight in a row, which I don't think too many other teams in the competition have been able to do that. So I guess we're very prepared for anything to face for the remainder of the season and through the playoffs, because there's really not too much we haven't seen already.
The run was far from over. Win number 11 in the streak was the sweetest when they trounced fierce rivals South East Melbourne Magic to the tune of 32 points. The Magic had lost eight regular season games, three of them against their Melbourne Park co-tenants. By the end of the regular season, Melbourne's momentum was enormous, with 13 wins on the trot, finishing second on the ladder behind the Magic. Of the six teams remaining with a shot at the title, they were now the hottest. With a bye in the first round of the playoffs, the Tigers sat and watched their semi-final opponents go through the paces. With a tough three-game series against the Canberra Cannons, the North Melbourne Giants stood between the Tigers and a grand final appearance.
Tonight's history-making semi-final between two of the NBL's most successful teams has been given an extra piece of intrigue with the inclusion of Giants centre Paul Rees. The big man was expected to be out for the year with a broken wrist.
I'm very excited at the prospect of playing tonight. Finals basketball is what you play the whole season for, and I've been fortunate enough to get back for this game.
What about the wrist? How's it feeling?
It's still quite sore, but I intend to get through it with enthusiasm and passion for the game.
Credit to him. You know, he's playing through some pain, and we're going to have to bandage it up. Obviously, Melbourne's going to be aware of it, and they're going to try to be whacking at it and pecking at it.
While the Giants are delighted to have Rees back in action, the form of his replacement, Andrew Goodwin, has given coach Brett Brown a headache he's happy to have.
It's a dilemma, but it's a much better problem to have than wonder where you're going to get your minutes or where you're going to get your points. I think that I can play them together. I don't see it being one or the other.
The Giants run into a red-hot Tigers outfit looking to extend their winning run to 14. But after a 17-day break, some of the heat may have gone out of the 93 champions.
I think that we've been training for so long and we've got a bunch of guys that are very mature and experienced. So I don't think, and I certainly hope, that the break doesn't break that momentum which we had towards the end of the season.
One Tiger looking to put his best foot forward will be one of Australia's newest citizens, Leonard Copeland.
Surprisingly, it doesn't feel any different. It's a good thing, though. I'm proud to be an Aussie. I'm still an American, but I'm proud to be an Aussie as well. And, just anxious to get out of here on the basketball court.
Amazing alley-oop doesn't come off to Copeland. It's all happening out there at the moment. Reedy, Mitchell for three. Timmons another rebound.
Timmons quick is dominating. What an outlet pass! What a pass by Marcus goodness, Timmons. Quite amazing. Have a look at the rebounding stats so far, dominated by the Tigers, and that man there, Mark Bradke, in for two.
Reedy. Bradke just too tall. To Timmons, who's away again. Foul on McDonald. And points count. Count that. Gaze. Fake the three to Timmons for two.
The Tigers opened strongly. A large Giants turnover count quickly handing Melbourne a double-figure advantage. With both imports struggling to score in the first half, it was left to David Stiff to ignite the Giants.
Shanahan for three. Oh, fantastic rebound. David Stiff.
A couple of late bombs from the Tigers gave them a handy nine-point break at the half.
Gaze for three.
He's taken a lot of attempts from that position. He was due to drop one sooner or later.
Gaze for another three. Gaze. Copeland for three. Sweet shot from Lenard Copeland. He's up to 13.
Early in the third term, the Giants set about hauling in the deficit. With the Tigers committing eight turnovers in less than 5 minutes, the baskets came cheaply.
Alley-oop pass to Stiff from McDonald was beautiful. Timmons lost it again. It's unbelievable. Really great pass to Johnson. He can't put it in, but McDonald's out of the way. Johnson. Oh, it's a victory.
The final term looked like belonging to the Giants, but in stepped Andrew Gaze, collecting 19 points for the term.
Gaze for three.
Oh, yes. Gaze off the screen.
Gaze, another three-pointer. Landed another one. 5 3-pointers for the game, and all of a sudden, Gaze is up to 28, and the Tigers lead by five.
Giants skipper Pat Reedy fired back, and we were set for an exciting finish.
Must score. Reedy for three. Does just that. Pat Reedy, a very big three. He's got 17, 2 points in favour of the Tigers.
Hasn't Reedy stepped up?
So both teams with their starters.
Johnson!
And Johnson big knocks down. Three. That's his fourth. Now, can the Giants get a stop? But the Tigers, it's got to get a good look at the hoop.
Timmons.
Gee, he did well then, Timmons, too. I thought he could almost gone all the way.
Gaze is on his own here.
Bradke. Now, who's the fouler? Is it Johnson? I think it is.
It was an early one. Tigers have hustled a little more. McDonald for two.
Oh, what a play! Warwick Giddy, that is an enormous block. Blocked by Timmons. And this is going to be the ball game. Andrew Gaze right on the buzzer, gets the two. Points count. Melbourne Tigers win game one of the semi-final series by eight. 107-99.
Tigers on three. One, two, three.
Tigers!
Three nights later, the semi-final show moved across the road to Melbourne Park. Ironically, the Tigers' last loss here at home was early July against the Giants.
I think every game that we played this year against North Melbourne has been that sort of game. But I thought tonight's game put a new standard of the competition that we've had throughout the year. That was the toughest game.
And finished the game with 17 points.
And there's a foul on Mitchell. Copeland's caught one in the eye from Pat Reedy, and he is down and hurt. Bradke missed the sitter. Now Gaze for three. In the corner, Andrew Gaze lands the three. It's the Tigers in front by one.
Similar to game one, it was the Tigers who were out of the blocks first. But a 7-0 run from the Giants saw the lead change again.
See Darryl McDonald taking the hole yet again for an easy two. But asking the Giants to show a bit more patience offensively in the half court, because he feels that if they are able to move the ball around a bit and make the Tigers play more than 10 seconds defense, they'll get easy shots.
And Mark Bradke goes up to Andrew Goodwin, and he is not impressed. Dishes to Goodwin. Misses the little right-hand hook, gets the ball back. Mitchell. Oh! Mitchell. How did he get that one in? Gaze up to 11. Of course, he got 39 in game one. Oh, great.
Oh, that's a defensive breakdown there.
Darryl McDonald was on a mission tonight. He clearly had made a decision that he was going to make things happen. And especially early in the game, that worried the life out of me.
With McDonald stamping his authority on the contest, the Tigers skipper took it upon himself to keep his team in the game. In the opening term, he didn't miss a shot on his way to 18 points.
Gaze, another three-point attempt. What can you say? Gaze throws up the shot. He is a freak.
Bradkey stepped up in the second quarter, handing Melbourne the advantage.
Bradkey in the paint, so it was a mismatch there.
He was just, you know, a physical presence. He's a man in there, and he's skilled in there as well.
Bradkey puts it in for two and draws the foul. He'll go to the foul line for the extra shot.
Provided that we're able to lift our game a little bit more and keep our nose in front, well, then I think it would have been a decent outcome. But I wasn't disappointed with what's going on. I was just trying to find ways of just making it a little bit better, because it was sure as hell not going to get any easier.
Again, just 2 points separated the teams. The third term belonged to the Giants, with both imports now doing the majority of scoring.
Offensive rebound, fadeaway jump shot by Mike Mitchell.
Now, we could have easily panicked at that stage and got 10 or 12 down, and that would have been really serious.
Melbourne responded with an 8-2 run, thanks to Leonard Copeland finding his range.
Nearing the halfway mark of the third quarter, Copeland spots up and triples.
Timmons. Look out.
Here's showtime. Quickly to Gaze. Oh, pinched by McDonald. He leads the NBL in steals, and that's why. And a brilliant basket from Darryl McDonald levels things up again.
With Gaze opening the final quarter with the first 5 points, the Giants' extended defence broke down, and Marcus Timmons reaped the rewards.
Kept it. Oh, my goodness.
Happy birthday, Marcus Timmons. He's done a Michael Clint. They're doing the backing up. Timmons again. Gordon, quickly to Timmons. He's shot down.
To have someone there either intimidating on defence or grabbing that offensive board where no one else does. You know, he seems to come from outer space sometimes and just pick up and rescue that that offensive rebound from a poor shot or a missed shot or something like that. And that's a huge, huge bonus, because none of our other players in the team do that.
Down the stretch, Timmons scored 15 fourth quarter points to make a clean sweep of the series and put the Tigers into the championship round.
He's caught, well, here he goes, he's caught 19.
See, he must have heard me. I didn't name him. So he's come out and knocked one down.
There wasn't a team in the land that looked capable of stopping Melbourne's explosive offense.
Melbourne Tigers are on their way to the South of Melbourne.
I feel very proud of the fact that I'm associated with this group of players, because there have been so many times that they've been tested. And the comment I made to our fellas after the game, many times players are able to perform to a very high level when things are going well. But the real test, I think, of a player's character and quality is when things are not going so well.
That's a quality team. You know, that's a quality team. Were they 21-6 last year? They won 15 games in a row. I would rate that as good as any team that's been in the league since I've been in Australia.
This is a game of two-up. You know, when you toss the coins, it's even money, heads or tails. And, you know, I've seen that each game, and the fellas certainly have gained strength and composure under pressure, because we've been under pressure since the halfway mark of the season.
The Tigers were now into their third grand final, and as was the case in two of those, it was South East Melbourne Magic who stood in their way. Having spent the majority of the season on top of the table, the men in black had little trouble eliminating the Perth Wildcats in their semi-final series.
So the South East Melbourne Magic are through to the 1997 NBL Grand Final, where they will defend their title.
Being in the playoffs 8 years in a row, like we have, that's one of the things I always tell the guys. You never know. If you keep getting in there, sometimes a part of this stuff is luck. You know, we get in, we finish first, we don't have to play a quarterfinal, then we get Perth, you know, maybe we'll go into the final series and Gaze will fall over. You know, you never know. So you, as long as you're in there knocking at the door, and this year, I think going right through, we've been very fortunate.
Step up! Step up! Stay down! Good help! Good help!
Before a ball had been bounced in the best of three championship series, the war of words broke out between the two camps.
What Ray Gordon does fires that team up, it fires him up, but it also puts it in the opposition's face. So you can't sit there as an opposing player and say, hey, I'll take that, I enjoy that. If we get an opportunity to stick it to Ray, we'll do it.
What's your reaction to that?
Well, I do get excited, but, you know, look, Brian's entitled to his opinion and he's been talking a lot lately. I mean, I think Brian's biggest worry about this week will be what type of pants he's going to wear. He's going to wear the tight ones or the loose-fitting ones. So, yeah, it's interesting.
What's your recommendation on the pants?
I'd go for the loose ones, Brian.
The pivotal battle is going to be staged in the middle. And again, there is no love lost between Bradkey and the Magic's tandem centres of Dorge and Anstey.
If you're just being honest about it, our two guys aren't really fond of him, aren't really fond of the comments that he's made, and he's not very fond of us or them. And you know, when you lay it down, that's the bottom line, and it adds, again, spice to what's going on out there. There's something under that, there's some background to it, and you know, it makes for a fiery little five-man competition.
Gaze for three. Makes it. Andrew Gaze is up for 5 points already.
As was becoming customary, the Tigers shot out to the early lead.
However, here come the Tigers. Gaze spots up, fakes the three. Bradkey.
The Magic struggled back to take the lead, but that only lasted a matter of seconds.
Has brought Magic back in line with the Tigers.
That was a ball for Andrew Gaze. He was a metre outside the three-point line when he shot that one. He's up to nine. Bradkey drives, takes on Anstey, and does it well. Well, so far, Bradkey is well and truly winning the battle between Anstey. Bradkey's got 7 points and four rebounds. Anstey.
First half, the Magic offense appeared stagnant, shooting at just 30% from the field. Confidence was down.
Bradkey, another big rebound and another foul.
You know, right now, that's the third foul on Tony Ronaldson, and Magic cannot afford to have the bear in foul trouble.
It's been a fairly well-kept secret that we do give some attention to defence. Sometimes we're successful, sometimes we're not. But it's not something that we ignore. We do try. And I thought tonight, particularly through the first half, it was our defence that established the break.
Copeland for three. Oh, very, very flat trajectory. But it still went in.
Leonard Copeland missed just one attempt from the field on his way to 19 first-half points, 17 coming in a remarkable second-quarter blitz.
Copeland. Andrew Gaze just made a beautiful cut to put the phone in.
What he does do, Stephen, is opens up a lane for Copeland.
It's a bit of a match-up in our favour with Brian Talbot on him. You know, we tried to make a focus of him and posting him up as much as we could, and I think the combination of that and him hitting some tough shots, which, I mean, I don't care who's on you, some of those shots he takes, it's very, very almost impossible to stop.
Back outside to Copeland. This will hurt them if he lands this one. Leonard Copeland's on fire. He's got 19. And look at the Tigers. They lead by 21 with 2 minutes still to go in the second quarter. Ronaldson for three. Dawes, good offensive rebound. Loses it though this time. Copeland. Quickly to Timmins! Showtime for Marcus Timmins! Bit early for a dance!
While curbing the Tigers' scoring power in the third term, the Magic's severe lack of offense and foul count kept them completely out of the contest.
Parkinson underneath. Timmins intimidated him out of it.
Timmins. Go all the way.
All the way! Coast to coast!
Tigers will go one up in this series.
Alley-oop! From Gaze to Egan, and the youngster, who's got a very promising future, just 18 years of age, didn't let his captain down. Drimmick ends up with the basketball. Tigers get it back. Egan to Smith. First points in the game to Blair Smith.
Jeffries
drives. Good move by Brett Jeffries. He's got plenty of ability. Andrew Gaze liked it.
72. Gordon did well.
Just hesitated enough to get the defense in the air.
Drimmick. Smith underneath, puts it in. Does the basket count? No, it doesn't. So the Melbourne Tigers have absolutely spanked the South East Melbourne Magic in game one of the grand final series. It's a record win to the Melbourne Tigers over the Magic. 111-74, an incredible performance by the Melbourne Tigers, and it's very hard to see the Magic bouncing back from this awful defeat as the Tigers gather midcourt to celebrate.
The huge 37-point margin equaled the mark set by the Magic in last year's grand final decider. Lindsay Gaze was in no mood to hear any more comparisons between now and then.
We've just been got our ass kicked, and everyone's talking about what happened last year, you know, and the one thing I'd like to remind you guys, we are a year older, believe it or not. Last year we were very old, weren't we? Old legs, you know, tired, can't play, beaten. We're a year older. And to expect complacency under the circumstances when we've been on the razor's edge all season. Now, we'll be very, very focused and very concerned about the fact that nothing less than what we did tonight is going to be good enough.
Whether you win by 50 or whether you win by one, it's just a win. And we've been in this situation twice before against the Magic, and we've lost the title. So although it's encouraging that we got the win, we enjoy that, but when we start again, and the game's on Wednesday, and it's irrelevant whether you win big or you win small. Doesn't matter.
We're all feeling bad. You can't suffer a 35 whatever point loss and not feel bad. It's simple as that. You know, I thought that I could never feel worse than the game three of the regular season this year against the Tigers, and when we lost by whatever. But I tell you what, I'm feeling a lot worse now. And but I mean, at the same time, I don't want to, you know, I don't want to be feeling like it's all over, because that's not at all the case.
The Tigers were riding high on a 16-game winning streak. One more and they would break the NBL record that had stood unbroken for 14 years.
I did make a comment after the game to say the streak is there, but that's taken away from you when the next team does it. The thing that they can't take away from is the championship. That's what it's all about.
Wounded but not out of it, the Magic conceded major changes were now required to keep this series alive.
We've looked at a few things in practice, you know, just as far as the lineups, what we start with, who we initially go with, and who we play. You know, I think some adjustments have to be made there, and a few minor adjustments to the structure.
The mood in the Tigers camp was, as always, relaxed.
You can't miss now, Jordan. You know that, right? You know you can't miss, right?
Ah! Oh, yeah! Ah!
As expected, the Magic benched Chris Anstey and Brian Talbot from Game 2's starting five. Some saw that as an act of desperation. The first sellout crowd of the season were treated to one of the best contests seen under the Melbourne Park roof.
And the big fella's off the ball. Dorge and Bradkey had a bit of a wrestle. Down the middle, McKinnon! Great start for the Magic. They lead 4-0. Larry Sensenbrock, how do you see the opening? It's Copeland for three, in and out.
Well, it's exactly like Paul was saying. I think the Magic have come out very, very aggressively in that timeout when the Brian Gorgian called.
Lindsay Gaze for the Tigers was talking to his team about helping on defence and recovering quickly, because he knows that the Magic are looking to make things happen. And that's exactly the way the game's gone so far.
Ronaldson inside for two. Missed doors, an offensive rebound. And he and Bradkey go at it again. Oh! And it's on here. Look at Dawes and Bradkey. Oh,
too much talking. If they want to get fair, and they've got to get on with it.
Drimmick for three.
He wanted it. He knew that was down the moment he caught the ball.
For Melbourne, it was again Timmins with a dominating opening turn.
He cleared the side of the court for Gaze. Here comes Bradkey for a little pick and roll. Ronaldson's given up his man. Timmins for three. Timmins. That is just punishing. Ronaldson left his man, which was Timmins. Timmins was all alone and just nailed the three.
Coming off the bench, Chris Anstey had a point to prove, and he did it immediately.
Gaze for three. That was under unbelievable pressure. He had no time to set himself, and Gaze is on the scoreboard. 12 points off. And the oath to Anstey! The one-handed jab. What a start for Anstey.
He's been under a lot of pressure, and tonight he shut it all up. Shut it all out, and he went out there and played basketball the way we know Chris Anstey can.
Look at Anstey on the lead. What a pass. What play by Chris Anstey. That's why he's going to the NBA.
And Bradkey has run into him after he put it in. And the foul. Is there a foul?
No foul.
No, there's not. I thought the foul was called.
But that's why the big fella's off to the NBA, because of his ability to get up the floor like that.
Copeland for three.
Magic again. Anstey on the break once again. Oh, Anstey's come out with all guns blazing, Stu.
Well, he had a shocker in game one, and he's almost been in hiding for 2 or 3 days. Hasn't shown his face. He's been pretty angry with just about everyone, but he's come out firing, proving a point tonight so far. Gaze.
Oh, it's Anstey again. He's intimidated that one.
Anstey had 13 first half points, but it was still Melbourne holding sway.
This will go up.
Gaze for three. Timmins! Oh, great tip in. Scores level again, 18 apiece.
And the pace has been frantic indeed. They just need to continue to put points on the board.
Timmins, great athleticism! Timmins. That is awesome!
Oh, a tiny opening on the baseline. Huge double-handed slam by Marcus Timmins.
That is one of the dunks of the year. Kelly. Smith.
Smith should have looked at the hoop on that play. They had the Tigers all out of position. Now Anstey's got to make the move. It's not the shot they want.
Timmins, the defensive rebound.
He's so fast, Steve, this series. I know we're just almost through the first quarter of the second game as Copeland nails three. But you have to say Marcus Timmins would be my pick right now for MVP of the series. If we were to stop at everything right now, he is doing the job. Talbot pushing the ball up.
Anstey. He's got 9 and 2 rebounds in very limited minutes. 3.5 minutes to go in the second quarter. The Magic, before those free throws, were on a 7-0 run. Kelly, oh, underneath. Gaze slipped over. 2 easy points for Mike Kelly, who now is up to 7, just 1 point behind the man he's guarding, and Andrew Gaze. Again, Kelly doing a great job. Best defensive player of the year in the NBL. Gaze for 2. Well, there you go. You give a guy a rap. What happens?
Well, he just uses the screen to perfection, and it was in no sort of a hurry there. He knew exactly what he wanted to do. Found some space and nailed it.
42-39, Tigers by 3. Talbot, Anstey underneath, is absolutely having a blinder. He is up to 11 points, which is now the equal game high. Paul Maley.
Well, I think a good sign for the Magic is the fact that he's scored a few hoops inside. Like, that was a very tough rebound. He went back up strong against Bradkey. He didn't go to the fadeaway or the little jump hook. He just took it straight to the racket. And Gaze responds with a monster three.
Andrew Gaze has now got the game high. 13 points, 10 points so far this quarter.
Well, Magic couldn't do anything more. That defensive play, Gaze off, no dribble, just stood there, nailed a huge three-pointer. Like, he was 6 or 7 feet behind the three-point line there. Drimmick on the drive, goes off the glass for 2. So Magic are hanging tough in what is an absolutely fantastic game. It's got everything in it.
Tigers by a couple. Gaze pushes Kelly out of the way. Now underneath for Bradke. Great assist, Andrew Gaze.
That's why he's won six MVPs. Kept his head up in that play. Got two defensive players out of the way. A little shovel pass underneath the Bradke, who finished with the big dunk.
Mark Bradke up to eight.
They're going to tip back to Talbot.
McKinnon. Misses. Smith, 2 seconds to go. Gaze from half court. Up it goes. At halftime here at Melbourne Park in game two of the grand final series. What a brilliant game it's been. It's the Tigers 47, the Magic 45. This match has had everything so far. Copeland. Copeland. Oh. Sweet shot. So he's found his hand again. Found the target. Leonard Copeland shoots up to 13 points. Tigers by three.
Isn't he focused? Oh, good catch by George. George did very well to read that because I don't think McKinnon meant it by any means. George did extremely well to hang on to that one and knock it in for two.
Copeland for three. Oh, makes it.
When he's in these moods, I tell you, he's
unguardable.
Yes, and there's no one that can stop him.
In the second half, Brian Talbot's class showed through, redeeming the effort in game one.
Surely the Magic got to score this trip up the court. They need a steadying basket. Anstey wrestling with Bradke.
You see, that stagnant sort of stuff's not what they want. They want to get some flowing motion. Talbot's got to look at it.
Talbot on the drive, makes it. So, Magic break the little hoodoo, and we've got a timeout here at Melbourne Park.
I thought Brian Talbot's effort tonight was exceptional coming off the bench, and you know, he has really stood up as a person in the last couple of days, and he took sole responsibility on Saturday night, and it wasn't just him, but just shows you the type of person that Brian Talbot is. And you know, tonight he came out and I thought he ignited us in that third quarter.
Talbot, that's an excellent basket for Brian Talbot. He's up to 6 points and it's the Tigers by three.
That's a sensational hoop by Talbot. Exactly what the doctor ordered, exactly what the coach ordered. And Copeland looking for the shot on the outside. Now to Gaze in the corner.
Blocked by Anstey.
For the block, but Copeland gets it back and knocks it down for the three. Oh, you just cannot keep these Tigers down.
That is heartbreaking for the Magic, isn't it?
Copeland again looking for the baskets. The running shot. Oh, Leonard Copeland.
21 to Copeland. Quick transition by the Magic. Talbot assist to Anstey. Great play, Magic.
Up by just one, heading into the final quarter, Copeland again threatened to open the game up.
Yeah, we're keeping the score down low at the moment. Their biggest problem is that man on your screen, Leonard Copeland. He has 25 points. They've done a good job on Gaze with just 16, although he's liable to go off.
The Magic's defensive specialist, Mike Kelly, was wearing down Gaze. Early in the term, he collected his fifth foul, and the Magic took full advantage.
Well, that puts a whole new complexion on the game. One more foul and Andrew Gaze is out of the game. It's the Magic by one. And you'd have to say, Paul Maley, the momentum now is with the Magic. Paul can't hear me.
Kelly from the corner. Oh, Mike Kelly! Magic with their biggest lead of the ball game.
Larry Senstock.
They're surprisingly calm. What they're looking at doing is they're making, as we saw in the couple of plays before the timeout, is putting Mark Bradke or dropping him down to the low block, having him cut to the basket. He hasn't done a lot of that this game, and he's been very successful in the past. Also, I think, in my opinion, I think they're going to go to Timmins a lot more. Timmins going to look for the ball. That's a huge shot there by Drimmick. Puts him out by five.
Frank Drimmick, a monster three. He's got 16. Gaze. Copeland for three. Can
Copeland.
He respond? He
oh,
can.
Oh, my. You won't see two better shots on either than those two. Drimmick right on the buzzer. Giddy comes up with a steal. Look at Gaze. Got Timmins in the corner.
Copeland.
Oh, the finger roll by Copeland.
Miss Bradke, the offensive board, puts it in for two. It's all level at 76 points apiece. 4.5 minutes to go. Scores level. Drimmick had a great game. So has Anstey. Kelly, outside Ronaldson, three-point specialist. Anstey, the offensive rebound.
We've got him up in the air too. Gee, he did well there.
Magic by two.
A lot of fakes under there by Anstey. Finally got Freddie to leave the ground.
Copeland. Oh, it's a hard shot to make. And he can't do it. Now Kelly. Fouls on Copeland. Just a sign of desperation there.
Well, he wasn't a bad foul, although I thought the Tigers had done very well to get back quickly. Kelly was the only Magic player in the front court at that stage. Both teams went to a huddle there. Big play for Magic. Drimmick's been outstanding, Stephen. 16 points at 71% from the field. He's yet to miss from the three-point line.
Kelly, 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Ronaldson works on Tinnens.
They get it out to McKinnon. Look for the penetration.
There's McKinnon.
Oh, he jumps over the top of it.
Misses. Gaze gets it for the Tigers. Now a chance for Melbourne to level it up again. They're down by two. There's the clock ticking away. The pressure out there is unbelievable.
Look for a three, Copeland or Gaze here.
Bradke. Shoots over the top of Anstey, can't do it. Well done by Anstey. Magic have got it again. Less than two to go. They lead by 2 points.
Both teams have gone a little stagnant offensively, but why wouldn't you? Unbelievable pressure out there at the moment. Every pass, critical.
McKinnon. Great screen by Ronaldson. Anstey, left-hander.
Oh, Anstey! Left-handed, maybe hook.
Magic by four. Tigers need a three.
Kelly is wearing Gaze like the club. Not leaving him alone. Ronaldson's got him on the switch. Timmons down low against Drimmick.
Timmons. Misses. Magic get it again. Foul is by Timmons, and you'd think the Magic.
Oh, Stephen.
Cool. Well, they've got their lead by four. Paul Maley.
Well, for the Magic, the clock is their best friend. They want to run some motion as often as they can. And on defense, same story. They're just going to get up and in and make it very tough for the Tigers. No threes.
Tigers must get a stop here. You'd think for them to have a chance in this game.
Pretty hard to say no threes against the Tigers. Kelly inside. Nice. Nailed it.
The Magic lead by 6 points with 40 seconds to go.
And what a game by Mike Kelly. Has 11 points.
Gaze for three. Oh. Misses. Here's another chance for the Tigers.
Gaze with just 16. Tremendous effort by Kelly. Copeland.
No misses. Call. No foul call. So the Magic are going to be safe in game two.
They're going to be back here Saturday night. What a game.
What a fight back. Kelly running down the clock.
Oh, the crowd, they're off to get their tickets now, I tell you.
You've got to hand it to the Magic. Oh. They were shot to bits after game one. Just, I tell you what, it's a very similar scenario to last year's final series. Except the Tigers this time get an extra day to rest. With their aging legs, that'll be handy. Listen to this crowd at Melbourne Park.
As I was saying, Mike Kelly, that's his 12th point, but the important thing for Kelly and his team, the fact that he has kept Andrew Gaze to just 16 points so far. A fantastic performance defensively. Hey,
what's everyone doing on Saturday? Gaze underneath, fouled by Anstey. His second personal for the game. So, Derby Day. Big race meeting at Flemington.
And there'll be a derby back here.
On Saturday night at Melbourne Park. Gaze at the line. And Mike Kelly, what a job he has done on the best player in the NBL. He's beaten him tonight, no doubt about that.
What a job by Chris Anstey off the bench.
And that is the game. We will have a decider on Saturday night at Melbourne Park. The Magic have won game two by 6 points, 84 to the Tigers, 78. And that man can, take a lot of the credit tonight. What a wonderful coaching performance from Brian Gorshin. Changed the entire Magic game plan and it's paid dividends.
In the post-game press conference, no one dared mention to Gaze Senior the similarities to that of 1996 and 92, when the Magic, after dropping game one, rebounded to win their two championships. Both were against the Tigers.
Well, I said, and I've said this very many times, whether it's within a game or within the league, it is not the progress result that counts, it's the ultimate result. So all of the things that might happen within a game or at this stage, it's the final result that really determines the whole business.
NBA-bound Chris Anstey in the swim and back in form for the Magic, leading the defending champions to one of the most remarkable form turnarounds in NBL history.
You know, I was personally disappointed with game one as well, so I didn't want that to happen again. So, it was the same as everyone. You know, I had to lift my game, and I think, you know, everyone on the team lifted their game. And
that starting John and establishing the way he did really created an opportunity for Chris to come in and get a couple easy baskets, and I think confidence was a big word for us after what happened in game one.
While Anstey fired up after being dropped to the bench, 19-year-old Frank Drimmick had a similar response to his promotion to starting five.
The starting game two definitely gave me a boost. And I came out and took my open shots and they went down. So it was a good result.
For the Tigers, who also hit the pool today, they've come face to face with the history of having lost two grand final series against the Magic in game three.
You know, we were... won all against Perth and we won it. So, I mean, we have positive memories as well as not so good ones.
While the Tigers skipper is thinking about the positives, he's had more than his fair share of problems with Defensive Player of the Year Mike Kelly, who held Gaze to just 23 and 18 points in the first two games.
Mike Kelly's the best defensive player in the competition, but having said that, the Magic are also the best defensive team.
Decider came around quickly. Suddenly, the thought was the Magic may hold the upper hand, having the younger legs. The Tigers' situation was fairly clear. A loss, and they would be labelled as chokers. A win, and they were the greatest team in NBL history.
McKinnon! And there's a big foul by Warwick Gideon. He's hit McKinnon in the face accidentally, but that's a good, hard grand final foul.
Absolutely, and what an effort by McKinnon to go to the basket. He really copped that one back. He was going to throw it down, tomahawk style. Have a look at this. Good, hard foul, as you called it. And he got him, there's no doubt about it. What a great effort by both players.
And Sam McKinnon's bleeding, and he has been sent off under the blood rule. And it's quite a nasty gash on the nose. That was a real hard foul from Warren Giddy. The way you should foul in the grand final. It's a tough game underneath there. It is very physical. And here's another angle and crunch right across the bridge of the nose.
Well, indeed, the first thing he said when he came down and sat down on the bench was, it's broken. And the team doctor has actually been pushing on his nose to try to get it back into a straight line. And bleeding fairly profusely at this moment. He is in some obvious pain.
Ronaldson for three. Doesn't go. Well done by Drimmick. Gets another offensive rebound for the Magic. It's 7-6. Timmins got the points for the Tigers down the other end. And Sam McKinnon at the moment off with a broken nose. Courtesy of a Warwick Giddy foul. Drimmick for three, and a sweet shot from Frank Drimmick, who for 19 years of age has had a brilliant grand final series.
In another titanic struggle, seven Magic players hit the score sheet in the opening term.
Magic get another crack at it. Rebounding at the moment, eight to the Magic, seven to the Tigers.
And again they get another chance.
Drimmick, Anstey underneath will score.
Three chances there for the Magic. They picked up the loose ball. Melbourne Tigers cannot afford to give up that many offensive rebounds.
Magic back in front by one. Gaze to Gordon, and Ray Gordon scores for two. And you can bet your bottom dollar that Ray Gordon, who's guarding McKinnon, will be working on that nose. He will be giving it a test out. You can guarantee it.
Again, Kelly was wearing Gaze like a glove. It took almost the entire opening quarter before he registered his first points.
A little bit stagnant, the Tigers.
They're down to 10 seconds. Look for Gaze. He'll work Kelly one-on-one.
Gaze off balance, makes it. Big basket. The first for the night for Andrew Gaze. And the Melbourne Tigers all of a sudden lead by seven, and they're up to 23.
For Melbourne, Bradkey had 11, and his team led by four at quarter time.
Got to shoot, Talbot. 2 seconds to go. Loses it. Here's a chance, Ray Gordon. Oh, missed it. Oh, Timmins! What a rebound! Sensational!
He was there all alone. That's a lifter.
Tigers by seven. Magic need to score this trip up the court. Ronaldson. Back outside. Talbot. Great assist to Ronaldson. Good defensive work by Bradkey. Now Kelly spots up. And triples. Big bucket from Mike Kelly. They needed that one, the Magic. His first points in the game.
The second quarter saw Gaze and Copeland tear the Magic apart.
Great stuff by the Magic. Copeland.
Oh, boy.
Leonard Copeland is up to five. And the Tigers lead by four.
A classic Copeland shot. One dribble to his right and straight up. Very quick off that dribble. And extremely difficult to guard.
McKinnon. Bradkey. Oh! Giddy on the ground did beautifully. Gaze. Copeland spots up.
Look out.
Triples! Great play, Warwick. Giddy down the other end. We've got to have a look at a replay of that one when we get some time. Talbot on the drive. Dawes can't put it in. Here come the Tigers again.
They're on the run, the Tigers.
Copeland for three. Misses. Timmins. Now Talbot. It's a Magic ball. Great passage of play from both teams. Substitution, a double one for the Magic. Let's have a look at this with Warwick Giddy. Off he went, onto the floor. Bradkey, Giddy, beautifully to Gaze. And Gaze in the end gave it to Copeland, who nailed the three.
Well, that's why, as Larry Singstock said, they are the most masters of the broken play. Really, they made something out of nothing from that one.
And Smith and Drimmick in for the Magic. Talbot and McKinnon having a break.
Critical point here for the Magic. 7 points is the equal biggest lead for the Tigers.
Kelly!
No.
Mike Kelly, 1 from 4 at the three-point line. So the Tigers walking the ball back up the court, lead by 7.
Remember, Chris Anstey saw only 4.5 minutes of play before he racked up 3 fouls. He's sitting down.
Gaze weaves his way through. Puts it in.
That's a good one by Andrew Gaze. If you look at the field goal percentages for both teams this quarter, and that is why the Tigers have gone to a 9-point lead. And Anstey warming up on the side, ready to check back in.
Drimmick. Ronaldson. Dawes, offensive rebound.
He's going to take that straight back up.
Ronaldson for three. And the bear makes it.
Gee, needed that one.
Tony Ronaldson. Well, Tony Ronaldson had 14 misses in a row from the three-point line in this grand final series before finally nailing that one. But Andrew Gaze down the other end says, anything you can do.
Well, that was from a long, long way out.
And it's a 9-point lead to the Melbourne Tigers. Drimmick, Ronaldson, starting to find some touch. That's a bear.
Ronaldson goes to the centre of the court very often. The Tigers have done a good job in this series pushing him towards the baseline, but all of a sudden they've stopped doing that, and I really think Giddey has got to try and push him baseline. You watch Ronaldson, he gets it, he loves to turn back inside to the paint.
Well, Tony Ronaldson's been averaging 7 points a game in this grand final series.
Gaze has got it. Gaze all of a sudden found the hot hand. He only needs 2 or 3 feet and he's going to get the feel. He's going to catch and shoot. Kelly's got to be right there in his shorts.
Now Drimmick. Magic need a score.
Big reach out by Warwick Giddey. Don't bring that in here.
Tigers have got the numbers. Gaze alley-oops it to Bradke. Misses a sitter. But Copeland tips it in.
Oh, what a play by Warwick Giddey at the other end. Really came from nowhere to throw that one away.
Timeout called by the Magic. Look at the Tigers. They're off the bench and they lead by a dozen. 40 to the Magic 28. Magic need a score. Drimmick off to the races.
Great
does
move.
Beautifully.
Again, he can't finish it.
Egan.
It's 3 he hasn't been able to finish Drimmick.
Gaze
on one.
To Copeland, steaming down the court at 100 miles an hour, and the Tigers lead by 14. Magic really need a score here to go into halftime with some confidence. McKinnon on the drive. What a dunk from Sam McKinnon.
Where's Smithson? Where'd that come from?
Gaze from half court. Lobs it. Oh, almost for Andrew Gaze. So at halftime in the deciding grand final game between the Melbourne Tigers and the South East Melbourne Magic, it's the Tigers leading by 14 points, 50-36, but this game is far from over. Copeland. Fadeaway jump shot. You cannot guard against that.
The break did nothing to cool Copeland's display of hot shooting. The Tigers got out by 19 with a quarter and a half to play.
Timmons, Copeland. For two, Leonard Copeland up to 18. It is the Tigers by 13. Nowhere to go at the moment. Copeland is free. Oh, Leonard Copeland. Oh, he is hot. He's got 20.
Oh, big screen off the ball. Giddey's poleaxed Mike Kelly.
Giddey blocked by Anstey.
Kelly's virtually out in his feet. He's
yeah,
not well.
Kelly is not well. He's got the staggers. He has got the staggers. And he has called a timeout. That was a big screen by Warwick Giddey. And it was very legal. Kelly just didn't see it coming. Let's have a look before a break. There's the screen. Giddey, bang, an elbow right in the jaw. The Magic have gone on a 6-0 run here to finish the third quarter. This is the last play of the third term. And it's a pretty big one for the Magic. If they can get a stop here, Dean.
Yep, they're right in this ball game.
Timmons.
They'll put some heat on the ball. They're going to get the pressure right on the player.
Copeland. God,
that is
fantastic. Leonard Copeland. That was a big shot at three-quarter time. And Ray Gordon likes it as he pushes Copeland off. And at the last change, it's the Tigers leading the Magic by 15 points, 70-55. Their fans think they're home. Paul Maley, how do you see it?
Well, Stephen, I think you and Dean were speaking about the next onslaught from the Magic after that timeout. I would expect to see it soon. I think Brian Gordon did an excellent job of G'ing the guys up. You see Mike Kelly putting in an easy two there. They really are going to crank up this press on defense and look for Brian Tolbert to really take it to the rim and try to create something offensively.
Larry Senstock.
I think out there you see some interesting matchups right now, but what they're looking to do, Tigers, is get the ball inside to the high or low post and then make sure they run off it, just like they did in that last play.
And Giddey and Tolbert put their bodies on the line there. Giddey's hurt.
Doesn't Giddey put in there?
Yeah, he is hurt. He's popped the corky on the hit from Tolbert. That was a great clash.
That was just good hard stuff. They went for the ball. Nothing in it, of course. Giddey going to the basket.
Oh, great assist. Warwick Giddey. Take your hat off to Warwick Giddey. He's not flashy.
Doesn't he
get the job done?
Not to be in him, with him in the trenches. There's a real go. Hasn't scored, but he's worth his weight in goal.
Kelly for three, and Mike Kelly does it. He's up to 11. 14 the difference.
Down the stretch, the Magic look to their co-captain to get them back in the contest.
Kelly, Ronaldson for three.
But look at
Mason.
He's off at the other end. They couldn't get it to him. Big basket there by Tony Ronaldson. 12.
12 the difference. They got to shoot. There's 6 seconds left in the shot clock. Gaze for three. Bradke. Now is a chance for South East Melbourne.
Colton's going to go all the way. Oh, he goes. Oh, Smith
over the top.
No foul on that play. It was good D by the Tigers, but Smith came from nowhere. We're under 10.
9 points the Tigers lead by. There is a chance for the Magic to produce something unbelievable here. Tigers have got to keep playing offensively. They can't.
Timmins inside will score.
Oh, that's a
Marcus
big play.
Marcus Timmins was isolated. One out. Alan Westover reckons that's enough.
Well, they had to keep playing offensively. They couldn't put the shutters up. Look at this dunk by Smith. Gee, you've got to take your head off to the Magic. And it's back out to 12 the difference with 2.5 minutes left.
The Tigers have been devastating from the foul line.
Talbot again. Big block by Timmins. Awesome. Have a look at Marcus Timmins.
And you just get the feeling. Andrew Gaze saying, guys, it's not over yet. But
Timmins is really ready to party.
It's not long.
Guys, I was standing on this side. It was like Marcus Timmins gave him a chance there. Oh, big steal there and a foul. It was like Marcus Timmins gave Brian Talbot a chance. He said, here you go, come on, come on. And then he just took off and threw it down into the floor. It was amazing.
Here is the block. Look at that. That is brilliant camera work.
And perfect timing by Marcus Timmins.
Sam McKinnon has fouled out meantime. Here's Timmins. And a little shake and bake here. Say that for later.
But that is all. This is finished.
Look at the bandages on Gaze. One on his elbow, two on his knees. Just over a minute to go, and the Tigers looking good. Alley-oop to Copeland, intercepted by Smith. Gaze gets it back. Copeland for two. That's 2 points. And look at the Tigers. They're starting to celebrate now.
And to celebrate now.
They lead by 14. Smith and Timmins off the ball. Not all that friendly. And some
streamers are coming in.
Overzealous Tiger fan has thrown some streamers. They can hang on for another minute and 2 seconds. They'll be able to do it. The Tigers, look at Andrew Gaze and Mark Brecky. They're already starting to hug and kiss.
Matt Moore's come on for the Magic. And without being disrespectful to the young man at all, but that's a sign that the white flag is well and truly up. For the Magic,
Matt there's Moore's Ray Gordon. Kissing Gordon. Every person on the Tigers bench. Kisses all around.
I don't know if it's worth winning if he's going to give you a snog.
Drimmick. Frank Drimmick for three. And you've got to take your hat off to the Magic.
They've had a real go, but really I think the best team.
Tigers too good. Gaze.
They are a brilliant team.
Second last earlier in the year, the Melbourne Tigers.
Now, there was some talk in the papers this week. If the Tigers didn't win this.
They were going to be branded as chokers.
Chokers, well. Yeah, there may have been a cause for that statement, but they've come out and done it in fine style and won this game. And as you say, hats off to Magic, but they're not good enough in this particular...
Warwick Giddey never made a three in his life. Never made a three-pointer in his life. Almost then. Turnover. Gaze. Andrew Gaze, a dunk! Oh, he couldn't get up there. Could not get up there. He tried, but he'll take the two. Melbourne by 13. Turnover. Parkinson gets it back. Andrew Parkinson spots up for the three and makes it. 10-point ball game. 93-83. Tigers running down the clock. And for the second time in their history, the Melbourne Tigers are champions of the NBL. They won the title in 1993 when they defeated the Perth Wildcats. And they've won it again for the second time. Look at Andrew Gaze with the Magic coach Brian Gorgian. It was a tough series for Magic tonight. A couple of their players were pummeled. McKinnon broke his nose. Kelly took a chunk out of his tongue. There's Ray Gordon. It was a great series, played in great spirit.
Fantastic series, Stephen.
There's the Gaze fan.
A beautiful picture.
Saw some great scenes back in Perth in 93 when they won it for the first time. And the Melbourne Tigers earlier in the year were second last. And they have come, produced one of the great comebacks in Australian sporting history, you have to say.
Oh, yeah.
To come from second last to win the championship.
One more loss in that period of time and they would have been written off. I don't think they could have even made the playoffs. They came up, finished second.
Chris Anstey there may have played his last game of NBL basketball. A few tears from Chris Anstey. He's off to the NBA. Sam McKinnon.
So those guys will come back. No doubt about that, but you've got to give all credit to this team right here.
Let's go courtside. Larry Sandstock speaking for the coach of the Tigers, Lindsay Gaze.
So I have got Lindsay Gaze here. Lindsay, is this the best team that you've ever seen in the NBL?
Well, I said before the start of the season that was the best team we'd ever had. I know people didn't believe me when we were 3-11, but when we got fit and we got healthy, they progressed from then on. We feel very, very proud of the fact that we've been able to beat a very good team tonight. Obviously, it never came easily, and I think the team showed a lot of character under extreme pressure. I think really they got the title that they deserve.
Mate, I asked your dad tonight. It's an emotional time for you. I thought it's the tears before.
Yeah, it's emotional, mate, because we're under the pump. Because if we hadn't lost this, I tell you, the media, everyone would have left us alone. So we were really under the pump and we come through big time.
The league would now like to name the player who has played the best over the whole series, the most valuable player for the grand final series. And ladies and gentlemen, there can be no doubt in this series it was Leonard Copeland.
And no one, Dean, would disagree with that. Copeland in his three games, 29 points, 28 points, and tonight 26 points. That's 83 points in three games.
Yeah, little doubt about that. And the thing was, he came up with the clutch baskets. It was when he got them, not just how many he got. And at the rate he hit them, he really did shoot the ball extremely well. Great percentage, up near 60% in the three games. So tremendous effort by Leonard Copeland and thoroughly deserved.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 1997 Mitsubishi Challenge champion.
Say this after game, the emotions get twisted. It's only tomorrow or the day after that all this will really sink in, and what you've done to get here. You see, the sort of thing that goes through my mind to say, who is there to thank? Millions and millions of people. As far as you guys are concerned, you've all made us proud, but my pride extends beyond to you guys who are doing most of the work. Like, your starting group work your ass off, and I'm thinking about the others, because without you we don't get anything. So thanks a lot for that. Well done. Hey! Hey!
Hey, on three, number one! What does it say? Number one! There's nothing to